What's up, everyone? Welcome to Velocity. It seems like everyone's vying for the WWE Championship on SmackDown these days. Brock Lesnar has a lot of superstars coming after the gold.
The following is a tag team contest scheduled for one fall, being led to the ring by Johnny Stamboli. At a combined weight of 480 pounds, the team of Chuck Palumbo and Nunzio, the FBI.
Chuck Palumbo and Nunzio will be in tag team action, but keep your eye on Johnny the Bull Stamboli during this tag team matchup. Josh Matthews will side with Bill DeMott. Here for Velocity
and
after Saturday night.
393 pounds, Paul London and Spanky.
It's going to be a big night here on Velocity. This past Thursday night on SmackDown, possibly the biggest night for Rey Mysterio in his career here in the WWE. If Rey Mysterio could defeat Brock Lesnar, then Rey Mysterio would get a title shot the next week on SmackDown. And now Paul London dropping Nunzio like third period Italian. I never took Italian in high school, Bill. They didn't have it in my school.
Is it Italian because it's the FBI?
Yeah, because they're Italian.
You win it.
Stamboli's Italian.
Chuck Palumbo now realizing that he has a huge size advantage over Paul London. Chuck Palumbo goes about 280 pounds. And now Palumbo taking it to the cruiserweight. Paul London here.
Chuck Palumbo is one of the guys vying for that championship gold, Josh.
Yeah, well, Brock Lesnar, this past week on SmackDown, Lesnar said he's the greatest champion of all time. And you got to admit, like Brock Lesnar or not, he is a tough competitor.
Like him or not, he's a tough competitor and he is the champion, but all time's a bold statement.
London goes up and over, and now Paul London using his speed and agility trying to take out Chuck Palumbo. London trying to take out the people-like legs of Chuck Palumbo.
The what?
He's got legs the size of people, Bill. Head scissor takeover there by Paul London. Oh!
He's got an arm like a people, too.
What a clothesline by Chuck Palumbo, and now Palumbo tagging in the Italian Piranha Nunzio. Straight toehold there by Paul London. And now blind tag to Spanky. Spanky and Paul London, the FBI. What's he waiting for? Oh, side rushing leg sweep clothesline there by Spanky. Cover by Spanky. Puts the leg. No kick out there by Nunzio.
So that double team maneuver is okay with you.
Well, yeah, you got 5 seconds to do a double team maneuver. Spanky London got it done in the allotted time. Cover, two. We're just playing by the rules, our Spanky and Paul London. They don't make the rules, Bill. Just like Oklahoma, Spanky and Paul London don't make the rules. They're just playing by them.
Just like Oklahoma, huh?
And the Oklahoma Sooners, they don't make up the BCS. They're just playing by the rules. Brian Conrad, a takeover there by Spanky. And now watch out. Here's Johnny the Bull Stamboli on the apron. And now the FBI have a two-on-one. Spanky.
They had 5 seconds and they used all five of it.
Cover by Nunzio, but Spanky too close to the ropes. Well, that's a little different.
Why, because the FBI?
No, because Johnny the Bull was on the apron, illegally distracting the referee, Nick Patrick.
Johnny the Bull was not in the ring, therefore he was not involved in the match. Nick Patrick needs to keep his attention in the ring.
It's funny how we see things differently, isn't it, Bill?
I hear you.
And that's my say. To the pack by Palumbo. You're stealing my Saints, dude. Cover by Palumbo, too. And a kick out by Spanky.
Again with dude. How many weeks?
I know Alice doesn't like
how many weeks,
dude.
Again with Alice?
You know me and Alice are close friends. Yeah! Now Chuck Palumbo. Using all of his leverage on Spanky here.
Take a look at Nick Patrick, Josh. I think he got punched in the face.
Well, anything can happen here in the WWE, and Chuck Palumbo just dropped Spanky.
Nick Patrick is bleeding.
Even the referees can get beat up here on Velocity. Now Nuncio after the quick tag by Chuck Palumbo. Spanky hard into the buckle, and now here comes the FBI 3-on-1 assault on Spanky.
But what you're not talking about is Paul London distracting Nick Patrick to give the FBI the opportunity.
Aggravated assault there by the FBI. 3-on-1. Johnny the Bull needs to be ejected from ringside. Johnny the Bull has no business at ringside in this matchup.
Then you put your headset down right now and tell Johnny the Bull to go to the back.
No, Bill, I'm trying to concentrate on calling the match. I don't have time to tell Johnny the Bull to go away.
You have time to point it out.
Spanky there makes the tag to Paul London.
Nick Patrick didn't see it.
Here's your turning point. Now here comes Paul London.
Nick Patrick's got problems of his own right now. He's got a bloody nose. That's going to hurt, and he's not seeing the tag.
And there's the cover by Palumbo, and there's Paul London. Paul London has seen enough. Referee Nick Patrick trying to keep Paul London at bay here. Spanky did make the tag to London. The referee didn't see it, so Spanky remains the legal man. And now Spanky sidesteps Palumbo. Palumbo shoulder first into the steel post.
He's really going to learn to stop with that steel post.
And Spanky, tornado DDT. Spanky finally gets Chuck Palumbo off of his feet.
Well, sure, London wants in now. Spanky's taking a hell of a beating, and now Paul London wants to play Superman.
Spanky needs to get the tag to Paul London. There's the tag to Nunzio by Palumbo, and here comes Paul London. Paul London, now big back chop there on Nunzio, running the House of Fire, trying to turn up here on Velocity, jumping, spinning leg lariat by London. And now Paul London, awful face. Cover, hooks the leg on Nunzio, and there's Chuck Palumbo to break up the pinfall. And Bill, we've seen it before with the FBI and Spanky and Nunzio. It's turned into a debacle.
It's turned into a debacle, but I gotta go back to Nick Patrick being on Queer Street. I don't think he knows what's going on right now.
Queer Street?
Discombobulated?
Discombobulated. Northern Lights suplex in stereo by Spanky in London. And what in the world is this? Muscle Buster.
That's more than five in my watch.
Cutter by London, hooks the inside leg, and there is Johnny the Bull Stamboli. Somebody needs to tell the Bull that this is a tag team match, not a six-man tag team match.
Well, the way London had him hooked, he wasn't going to beat Nunzio like that anyway, Josh.
That's not the point, Bill.
What's the point?
Missile drop kick there by Spanky, a senton to Nunzio. And now Spanky is taking out all three members of the FBI. London's got the cover on Nunzio. This is going to do it. Spanky and London, no!
The point being, Josh, if Stamboli doesn't belong in the ring, then Spanky doesn't belong jumping out to the floor to stop him.
Paul London just got whacked from about 14 feet in the air. And Nunzio picks up the victory.
There are your winners, Chuck Palumbo and Nunzio, the full-blooded Italians.
Paul London going for the Hurricane Rana out of nowhere. Chuck Palumbo delivers the whack. And the FBI pick up the victory, but in my opinion, the entire FBI picked up the victory thanks to a little help from Johnny the Bull Stamboli.
That leads us to this week's turning point, Josh. It's not so much a turning point in the match, but nonetheless, at the top of the match, Chuck Palumbo goes for the win, Spanky goes to kick out, and punches referee Nick Patrick right in the face. Now, it doesn't have much to do in the outcome of the match, but it goes to show you that even the referees get physical in the WWE.
Bill, there were bodies flying all over the place, but in the end, thanks to Johnny the Bull Stamboli, the FBI pick up the victory. It's going to be a great Velocity. Billy Kidman's in action, and I get to hang out with you.
I'll tell you what, Josh. The action with the FBI is only to start. The Cruiserweight title is on the line tonight. Tajiri defends the title against Billy Kidman. Kidman's been out with a knee injury, and what an opportunity to come back on Velocity for the Cruiserweight Championship.
Oh, it's going to be off the hook, but up next right here on Velocity. The A-Train suffering from a loss against Shannon Moore. The Big Show and Matt Morgan had a lot of money riding on that one.
This is scheduled for one fall. Approaching the ring from Nagoya, Japan.
pounds, Tony Schiavone.
Join the WWE Superstars in supporting Operation USO Share Package. Go to troops.wwe.com for more information. And by WWE SmackDown, Here Comes the Pain, available for the PlayStation 2.
And by Lugs, who presents the latest Funk Master Flex driving shoe, the Vantage Lugs, the streets are ours. I feel like I'm back in Brazil, Billy. Ultimo Dragoon watching soccer. Goal! Olé, 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 olé.
No? You like that? I really miss Tony Chimmel.
I hear you. Ultimo Dragon in the silver, Tony Cilantri in the neon green, set for Cruiserweight action here on Velocity.
Mike Sparks in SmackDown Blue.
Speaking of Cruiserweights, Bill, when is Paul Heyman going to stop the madness with Shannon Moore? Shannon Moore has been put through hell the last month.
Shannon Moore? I don't know what keeps him coming back every week, to be honest with you. I don't know what keeps Shannon Moore coming back. And it's not his name. I'm not buying into that.
Covered by Cilantri, kick out there. And now Dragon catches the boot, and a back spinning kick there by Dragon. Look at this. Flying head scissors by Ultimo Dragon. You look at Shannon Moore's dance card over the last month. Matt Morgan, Nathan Jones, The Big Show, and the A-Track.
Dance card.
Up and over goes Ultimo Dragon with the plancha, and now Dragon taking it to Tony Cilantro. I mean, what's next for Shannon Moore? Brock Lesnar?
It might as well be. It might be Shannon Moore's only shot at the heavyweight title.
And Ultimo Dragon now staying on top of Tony Cilantri, covered by Dragon 2. I wonder what the FBI have, and I wonder if the FBI has odds on this match.
I wonder who's got money on it.
And now Dragon scooping a slam, and here comes Ultimo Dragon working on the legs of Tony Cilantri. Paul Heyman says he doesn't hold a grudge against Shannon Moore, but Paul Heyman keeps putting Shannon Moore in these ridiculous matches.
Apparently, Matt Hardy had some kind of relationship with Paul Heyman. I'm not happy about Matt Hardy. I'm not happy about Matt Hardy going to Raw, but Shannon Moore is paying the price week in and week out.
Yeah, but you got to give Shannon Moore credit. He's got the guts to come out each and every week, take a beating, and this past Thursday night on SmackDown, Shannon Moore shocked the world with the victory over the A-Train.
Shannon Moore, I don't know what to say about Shannon. What keeps him going?
It's a good question, Bill. The desire to win, the desire to be a superstar here in the WWE, that's what keeps Shannon Moore going.
Sometimes you just have to know when to say when.
But Shannon Moore beat the A-Train.
And he took a beat by Matt Morgan.
Yeah, but then Matt Morgan in the Big Show gave the A-Train a beating. All because the A-Train bet against Brock Lesnar 2 weeks ago. Sunset flip by Cilantri, and now goal! Goal by Dragon! Covered by Ultimo, Dragon hooks the leg, and Cilantri gets the kick out after a one count. Paul Heyman obviously upset with the A-Train, sicking Matt Morgan in the Big Show all over the A-Train this past Thursday night on SmackDown. That's what you get when you bet against Brock Lesnar, Bill.
We really got to wonder, whose money are they betting with that's got Paul Heyman so upset? Is it Paul Heyman's money he's losing, or are they betting their personal money? Either way, money is tearing apart Team Lesnar.
And now Dragon blocking the forearms by Cilantri, the clothesline attempts, and now Dragon lighting Cilantri up like a Christmas tree.
This is the Dragon I remember.
Or a Hanukkah candle, whatever your preference is. Asahi DDT, cover by Dragon, and that'll do it. A very impressive victory for the Cruiserweight from Mexico City. Eddie Guerrero lying, cheating, and stealing with an air filter. Los Guerreros will get it done any way they can.
The following contest is scheduled for one fall. Introducing first from Miami, Florida, weighing 240 pounds, Orlando Jordan.
There isn't much we can say about Orlando Jordan that we haven't said in the past here on Velocity. Inside that ring, Orlando Jordan can get it done, period.
Who better than Canyon?
And from Puri, New York, weighing 242 pounds, Canyon.
And don't forget,
forget this upcoming week on SmackDown, a huge opportunity for Rikishi and Scotty 2 Hotty live this Thursday in Florida. The Basher Brothers defending their WWE Tag Team titles against Rikishi and Scotty 2 Hotty. And don't forget, Rikishi and Scotty own a pinfall victory over the Bashers that happened a couple of weeks back on SmackDown. And now Rikishi and Scotty 2 Hotty just skyrocketed themselves up the rankings as the tag team here in the WWE. And they will have that shot to take the titles away from the Bashams this upcoming Thursday night on SmackDown.
You gotta wonder what role Shanique was gonna play in this, since she's so unhappy with the loss to Rikishi and Scotty 2 Hotty the first time around.
No doubt about that. Try to keep your eyes on Shanique. Orlando Jordan and Canyon going one-on-one right here on Velocity. This isn't the first time that Orlando Jordan and Canyon have locked horns here on Velocity.
The fourth time, the fifth time? How many times?
I don't know, Bill, but I believe that Orlando Jordan has never lost to Canyon.
Never lost to Canyon, but he's never going to move up until he gets this monkey off his back.
Billy's beaten him three or four times now.
Apparently hasn't done it well enough because Canyon's back every week. Something's got to be proved to Canyon, or Orlando Jordan's got to prove something to me.
Well, now Orlando Jordan on the offensive on Canyon right now in the center of the ring. Orlando Jordan knows Canyon very well, as Canyon knows Orlando Jordan very well. Fireman Carey take over there by OJ. Cover, doesn't hook the leg, and Canyon gets the shoulder up.
I mean, you look at Canyon's resume. WWE Tag Champion, WCW Tag Team Champion, WWE US Heavyweight Champion, and ever since he's been hurt, a knee injury, a shoulder injury, he can't get back on track. Canyon is fake. Orlando Jordan is the monkey on his back. So Canyon needs one good win, and Orlando might be that win for Canyon to get back where he belongs.
Well, Canyon's resume is all very well and good, Bill, but you got to look at what Canyon is doing right now, and he's lost to Orlando Jordan the past few weeks on Velocity. Now Canyon going to try to defeat Orlando Jordan. Orlando Jordan's going to try to do the same, and that's what's going to happen this upcoming week on SmackDown in the Tag Team Title Match. We did the Bashams, Rikishi and Scotty. A kick out there by Orlando Jordan. You got to know that Los Guerreros will probably, most likely, have a close eye on that Tag Team Title Match. Los Guerreros would love to get the tag team titles back in their possession.
I think every week we ask the question now, Los Guerreros would love to have those titles back in their hands, but can they make it another week? Can they get along? Yeah, they're a volatile family. Yeah, they're aggressive. But man, what keeps these two together?
Well, Bill, I told you last week, when Eddie Guerrero and Chavo Guerrero are getting along, there isn't a better tag team on SmackDown. Cover there by Canyon, two, and out. Oh, so close to Orlando. Jordan just barely gets the shoulder up. Hell, there might not be a better tag team in all of the WWE. I dare Raw to produce a better tag team, like I said last week, than Los Guerreros when Eddie and Chavo were on the same page.
Well, I agree. Nobody can stand up to the Guerreros, but it seems like Eddie thinks there's something wrong with Chavo.
Wait, hold on 1 second. Cover by Canyon and a kick out there by Orlando Jordan.
Eddie thinks that Chavo's got some personal issues. We already know about Eddie's personal issues. Can these guys withstand any more personal problems and not bring it into the ring?
Well, Chavo Guerrero feels that Eddie is stealing the spotlight. Los Guerreros did manage to beat the self-proclaimed world's greatest tag team this past Thursday night on SmackDown, but Chavo wasn't happy because Chavo wanted to pick up the victory after his strong splash.
But it's a tag team, Junior.
Cover again by Canyon. Two and a kick out by Orlando Jordan after the tight cover by Canyon. And a rear chin lock applied here by Canyon. Canyon trying to ground Orlando Jordan right now in this matchup. Canyon knows Orlando Jordan very well. We know Orlando Jordan can fly.
Canyon is known as the innovator of offense, but he knows by now, the fourth meeting with Orlando Jordan, this is not going to get it done. Canyon's got to step it up.
Well, if Orlando Jordan wins this matchup, then it will be a sweep here in the World Series of Velocity. Orlando Jordan with the boot to the face, and now OJ had a scheme. Flying forward by Orlando Jordan. And now OJ's starting to feel it. This arena's starting to feel it. And now Orlando Jordan sends Canyon for the ride. Big time back body drop there by Orlando Jordan. And here we go. Perhaps a little Johnson shuffle coming up for Canyon. There it is. Bang! Cover by Orlando Jordan. This has got to do it. No, Canyon barely slips that shoulder up.
What's it going to take to end this rivalry?
That's a great question, Bill. I have no idea. No idea.
Orlando Jordan ducks the right hand there by Kanyon. And now Orlando Jordan boots to the midsection. And here's Kanyon, the innovator of offense. Side rush election. Float up. Cover. Two and a half. And Kanyon failed to hook the leg on that
attempt. With a cover like that, this is why he's getting beat every week.
And now Kanyon shooting Orlando Jordan off. Nope. Kanyon into the bucket. Kanyon goes up and over. Caught up by Orlando Jordan. And now Orlando Jordan. Huge power slam. Cover. And Orlando Jordan beats Kanyon again.
There's the winner, Orlando Jordan.
Orlando Jordan is a player. Orlando Jordan is money. And he proves it each and every week right here on Velocity. Kanyon's now felt the wrath of OJ four times.
And up next on Velocity, Billy Kidman wants to get his hands on that Cruiserweight Championship. Kidman's been out of action with a knee injury and is dying to get in the ring with the champion, Tajiri and Kidman, tonight.
Shibby. I know the SmackDown superstars cannot wait for that great opportunity.
The following contest scheduled for one fall is for the Cruiserweight Championship. Approaching the ring with Akio and Sakota from Japan, weighing 206 pounds, the Cruiserweight Champion, Tajiri.
The Japanese buzzsaw Yoshihiro Tajiri defending his Cruiserweight Championship tonight, right now, right here on Velocity. Champion Tajiri, but you got to keep your eye on those two henchmen right there, Akio and Sakota, because they'll be keeping their eye on Tajiri.
You know, we can talk about the henchmen all night long, Josh, but the bottom line is this: Tajiri is the Cruiserweight Champion. He wears that gold for a reason. With or without the help of Akio and Sakata, Tajiri is still the champion.
I'm not taking anything away from Tajiri. He is a very great Cruiserweight Champion, Bill. I mean, Tajiri can get it done in the ring. There's no doubt about that. On the mat, on his feet, the buzzsaw is a lethal weapon. But you also have to keep your eye on Billy Kidman. Kidman's been out of action for a while, and now Kidman's back, and he's going to try to take the Cruiserweight Championship away from Tajiri. Snapmare there by Billy Kidman. This one's going to be quick, Bill.
Well, Kidman being a former champion himself, he knows what it takes to get it done in the ring, but he also knows he's got two guys watching him on the outside.
Billy Kidman goes up and over, caught up by Tajiri, but Tajiri was caught by Kidman, and now Tajiri gonna try to get a breather here, but Billy Kidman says, Billy Kidman, baseball slide to Tajiri. Billy Kidman doing the right thing here, put Tajiri back in the ring. That's where Kidman needs to defeat Tajiri, and now here comes Akio, and there's Sakura with the clothesline.
And you said it, that's what he needs to keep Tajiri in the ring, but Kidman knows, Kidman's a veteran. You don't go outside when you got two henchmen outside watching Tajiri's back.
And Billy Kidman was in control of this matchup, covered by Tajiri, and a kick out there by Billy Kidman. Akio and Sakota, they will be the difference maker in this matchup, Bill. Knee right to the jaw there of Kidman. Covered by Tajiri and a kick out.
And did you see where Tajiri dug his elbow into the jaw? He just dropped the knee on.
The Cruiserweight Champion now. Submission hold applied to Billy Kidman. Bill, what in the world is this kind of submission hold?
Tajiri is skilled. He is just cutting off. He's not so much cutting off the air, but he's putting pressure on that collarbone. He's putting pressure on the jaw he just dropped the knee on, the forearm he just dug into Kidman's throat. He's putting pressure. He works the same area. You beat a man by wearing him down.
What? Billy Kidman back to a vertical base. Billy Kidman trying to break up that submission hold. Kidman successful, and now Billy Kidman trying to get back on the offensive in this matchup. Tajiri catches Kidman once again, and now an electric chair. Oh, an electric chair right out of the top rope.
And right back to that jaw area, right back to the top of the
and
throat.
Another cutter by Tajiri, and a kick out by Billy Kidman. Tajiri, well-versed in submission holds, the Cruiserweight Champion, much like our WWE Champion, Brock Lesnar, who applied that Brock Lock to Rey Mysterio this past Thursday night on SmackDown, forcing Rey Mysterio to tap out. But you have to give credit to the 175-pound extreme luchador Rey Mysterio. Mysterio brought the fight to Brock Lesnar.
Mysterio had the right idea. He had Brock on the run. He had Brock chasing him, but you can't beat the champion running around the outside of the ring. You have to beat him in the middle. One, two, three.
And of course, then we saw Hardcore Holly dressed as a family member of Rey Mysterio. Hardcore Holly out of the crowd. Hardcore Holly trying any way, anyhow, to get to the champion, Brock Lesnar. Hardcore Holly wants to get his hands on Brock Lesnar.
Hardcore Holly sat in that arena for two long hours, watched everything that went on all night in a mask, dressed like Rey Mysterio, waited for the opportunity, and when the opportunity came, Hardcore Holly took advantage of it. He took off that mask and went right after the champion, Brock Lesnar.
And Tajiri trying to take advantage of Billy Kidman. Kidman saw the handspring coming. Kidman ducked and nailed the dropkick. The Cruiserweight Championship hangs in the balance. Both superstars are down. Akio and Sakoda watching on. Billy Kidman needs to get to his feet, as does the champion, Tajiri. A lot of separation right now between Kidman and Tajiri. Kidman up, Tajiri up. Kidman ducks the spinning kick and a spinning back elbow by Kidman. Billy Kidman is feeling it. Billy Kidman knows that this is his opportunity to win the Cruiserweight Championship. Springboard bulldog by Kidman. Go for the cover. There it is. Hooks the leg of Tajiri. New champion, and Tajiri just kicks out. Bill, the championship could change hands right here on Saturday night, right here on Velocity.
Well, Kidman's been cleared. Boom!
What a kick by Tajiri, right to the temple of Kidman. Cover two, and Kidman. Billy Kidman had enough in the tank to kick out.
Kidman's been cleared by the doctors, but there's no replacing ring shape. Kidman's been out for a long month. You gotta wonder if he's physically able to get back in the ring and go toe-to-toe with Tajiri like this.
Roll up by Billy Kidman. Tajiri stacked. And Tajiri again using his lower body strength to kick out. And another kick to the side of the head by the buzzsaw Tajiri. And now Billy Kidman is caught in the web of the tarantula by Tajiri. An illegal maneuver, but the damage to the lower back, it only takes a couple of seconds, Bill.
You saw the look on Kidman's face. Tajiri scouts his opponents. He knows Kidman's had trouble with his back, and he's taking advantage of it.
Kidman ducks. Oh, it's Suguri by Billy Kidman. Billy Kidman is perhaps one move away from becoming the Cruiserweight Champion. And that one move, Bill, is the shooting star press, and Billy Kidman knows it.
Kidman can't let the people tell him how to win this match. He should have come to break when he had him on the mat.
Billy Kidman's Kidman's gonna be the new Cruiserweight. And Akio sweeps the leg of Billy Kidman. Billy Kidman had this match wrapped up. All Kidman needed to do was hit the shooting star press. Akio nails Tajiri. Kidman nails Akio. BK Bomb, new Cruiserweight Champion on Velocity. Tajiri barely kicks out.
Kidman can't believe it.
I can't believe it.
Does Kidman have enough left in the tank to become Cruiserweight Champion?
Billy Kidman needs to stay on Tajiri right now, right here. Billy Kidman has the opportunity to become the new Cruiserweight Champion. Tajiri slips out. Hurricanrana by Kidman. Shoulders are down.
Oh, he's out.
Tajiri breaches up. Buzzsaw kick to the side of the head. And Tajiri retains his championship.
The winner of this match is still Cruiserweight Champion, Tajiri.
Billy Kidman was one move away, but you gotta give credit to Tajiri. After a hurricanrana by Billy Kidman, Tajiri breaches up. There you see another look at it, Bill.
Tajiri's out, and bam! Kidman's out.
Just when you think you have the buzzsaw down and out, Tajiri breaches up from nowhere and Tajiri retains his Cruiserweight Championship right here on Velocity. But you got to give credit to Billy Kidman. And now, Billy, you and me are headed to SmackDown, but don't go anywhere because Confidential is now.